Hello Cloud Gurus and welcome to AWS This Week, and I have some incredible announcements to tell you about this week, including EC2 Key Pairs gained some new management features, EC2 now supports NitroTPM and UEFI Secure Boot, CloudWatch events can now receive notifications that are generated by Amazon machine images, and registration is now open for the AWS EMEA Summit online. You're watching AWS This Week with me, Faye Ellis. EC2 Key Pairs have recently gained some new management features. A key pair, consisting of a public key and a private key, is a pair of security credentials that prove your identity when connecting to an EC2 instance, over SSH for example. Using the AWS console or CLI, you can now view the key creation date and public key material for all key pairs created in your AWS account, whereas previously you could only view a list of the key pairs and their assigned tag. So this is great if you would like to audit your key creation dates and make sure that keys are being rotated in line with company policy. And in addition to this, you can now also create and delete key pairs using CloudFormation templates, which is very cool. EC2 now supports NitroTPM, and TPM stands for Trusted Platform Module, and it represents an international standard for dedicated, separate crypto processors that are designed to carry out cryptographic operations like generating, storing, and controlling access to encryption keys at a hardware level. And this technology is now available for EC2 instances that run on NitroTPM powered hypervisors. And this will allow Nitro-based EC2 instances to generate, store, and use cryptographic keys without even having access to them. And it can also handle platform device authentication using the TPM's unique RSA key, which is burned into the physical hardware. So this is great for workloads that have very specific security requirements that up until now could only be satisfied by running the workload on your own hardware. EC2 now also supports UEFI Secure Boot, and this stands for Unified Extensible Firmware Interface. It's another industry standard specification, this time for the software interface that handles communication between an operating system and the platform firmware. Secure Boot is a feature that uses a digital signature to verify the integrity of software that boots and runs on your EC2 instance, and it will even halt the boot process if the signature verification fails. For instance, if the software has been altered or tampered with by a malicious actor. EC2 now sends notifications to CloudWatch events for a variety of Amazon machine image status changes. For instance, creation, registration, and deregistration of an AMI. And this allows you to then initiate further actions based on these events, such as triggering Lambda to automatically launch a new instance using a new AMI that's just been registered, or sending out an SNS notification about the deregistration of an existing AMI. And finally, registration is now open for the AWS EMEA Summit online, which is happening next month on June the 29th. This event is free of charge and available for everybody to attend. And it's a great opportunity to hear technical talks from AWS experts, partners, and customers, and even participate in technical breakout sessions, demonstrations, and workshops. Well, that is all for this week. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. Take care of yourselves, and I will look forward to seeing you soon.